Hey folks, this is Best of Slot and welcome to Jurassic World Evolution 2. Very exciting times. Today we're going to start our campaign playthrough, but I thought I'd show you the main screen. We've got our campaign, we've got challenge mode, we've got sandbox, and of course we have the brand new Chaos Theory, where we're playing all of these in the coming days, weeks, months, and inevitably years. Another thing I want to show you very quickly. The newsletter has a sign-up thing. I can't sign up right now, but it's got the 29 Jeep from Jurassic Park, from Jurassic World. Even this is the one they rigged together, I believe, to escape from the old visitor center. But in this rusted, torn-up kind of form, it actually looks really, really cool. And I really want it, but I'm not allowed it. It's very sad. Other than that, good to go. You can see I've done a teeny tiny bit of the campaign. I was just doing sound testing, stuff like that, as per YouTuber nonsense, basically. Really excited to get started on this. Really curious about where this campaign is going to go. Let's crack on, shall we?
Jurassic World. This is where our story begins. Scientific breakthrough without any consideration of the consequences. So nature did what it does and unleashed chaos. This time, we were deeper into the illusion of control, and the chaos brought something much worse. And for a moment, we remembered how precious life is. But time has a funny way of softening our memory of what it's like to lose control. And ambition. Ambition is a persistent thing. For the dinosaurs left behind, time was becoming immaterial. From miracles of science to assets destined for exploitation. Perhaps it's time we reflect on the true nature of nature. An endless cycle with one goal, survival. And this means that dinosaurs and humanity have to find a way to work out their differences.
I can't be the only one who gets super hype from those videos. They're really good. And I'm hopeful every Chaos Theory mode has one. We've only seen the San Diego one, but... whew, chills. Anyway, here we go. Arizona, big dry dinosaurs, just the way we like them. Let's get started.
To us, a desert is a wasteland, devoid of anything but the most extreme examples of life. But creatures once thrived in these lands hundreds of millions of years ago. Given the geological history that we're dealing with, dinosaurs walking among the tumbleweeds isn't that much of a stretch. The current situation, where dinosaurs are running wild, is untenable to those in charge, well, those that think they're in charge. So, we're left with a problem or an opportunity. This is where you come in. They've ignored my warnings before, but maybe this time with you, it's going to be different. I'm willing to embrace the uncertainty.
Ian Malcolm, definition of insanity, keeps coming back. Keeps getting burned every time, but he keeps coming back. Here we are.
Okay, I guess an introduction is in order. I'm Cabot Finch, Assistant Director of the U.S. Department of Fish and Wildlife. I know it sounds important, because it is. But let's not get bogged down in labels and titles and organizational flowcharts. I'll make this easy. You work for me. See? Nothing to it. You'll be working with the experts. This is Claire Deering and Owen Grady.
And yes, we have first-hand experience with the dinosaurs. I'm the former operations manager at Jurassic World. Owen and I actually helped build the park. And unfortunately, we were there to witness its destruction. And this is Owen. He works with velociraptors.
You could call me a dinosaur wrangler, though officially I'm an animal behaviorist. I was just building a level of trust with them when this happens.
Okay. So we'll need to get a few things in place ASAP. start with a response facility, equipped with both a Ranger Team 4x4
and a Capture Team helicopter.
Alright then, here we go. Tutorial level, of course. Expect things to be a little slow right here at the start as we build our response facility, helicopters and Ranger teams. It's like a surf and turf, but not really. And we need a backup generator.
We are making excellent progress, so let's stay focused. Next step, building a backup generator. Then feeding the energy it creates to the response facility. And also make sure the building is connected to the PATH network. It only does us good if it's operational.
These things are interesting because this little generator over here is evil. This little generator is why I went bankrupt in my first Chaos Theory attempt. Oh, you really want me to align the void, don't you? Okay. That's interesting. Anyways. We're gonna be chill. You know, we've played a lot of Evolution, so I kind of know the ins and outs quite deeply. And hell, I've played Evolution 2 for 4 or 5 hours already. But I wanna savor the moment. There we go. New response facility.
Hey, Claire. We may have trouble tracking this dinosaur from the ground. And even more trouble if we're lucky enough to find it.
Then, the sensible thing is to take a Capture Team helicopter. You can track it from the air.
See? I like the way I think.
Okay, so our first wild dinosaur capture. Locate and tranquilize the nearby, much less ugly, wild Baryonyx. Okay, now, doing this for the very first time on YouTube. We're gonna have very, very good aim, aren't we? Yes, yes we are. God damn it. I shouldn't have said anything. I brought this on myself, I'll admit. Oh, nice. Second hit, got it. Oh, ooh. Looking a little sandstormy over there.
Claire, this is Elle.
I copy you.
We have it. Capture successful.
I knew you'd do it. Never had a doubt.
Really?
Well, maybe one or two.
Well, it's better than usual. I'll take it. Now, where do we take this dinosaur?
We have the enclosure. We just need you to deliver.
Hey, don't I always? Wait, you don't have to answer that.
Sorry, I should read those. It's just saying that we've got time controls now. We can speed up time a little bit, or we can speed up time a whole lot of bits.
John Hammond was concerned about what would happen if dinosaurs lived in the wild. It adds a whole new level of challenge. And perhaps, opportunity.
Isn't that beautiful? It's almost majestic if it wasn't this floppy dinosaur flying through the air. The way the sandstorm kind of blots out the sky almost is pretty cool. Oh, there's something I need to check. Does NVIDIA Ansel still exist? Oh, you little stunner. Little stunner. Okay, good to know. Good to know. So this is the new and improved Baryonyx. I've got to say, it's gone from being a bottom five dinosaur in the game to me to being pretty cool in a way, actually. The eyes are so much better and it doesn't have that really annoying pink color around the mouth anymore. It's really improved.
I instantly recognize this dinosaur. Kind of hard to forget once you've been trapped in a room with one. We couldn't save that Baryonyx, but we can certainly help this one.
I'm very curious about the plotline for this game, I really am. Because, save the dinosaurs, inverted commas?
There's not a lot out there for the dinosaur to consume, so we'll need a feeder inside the perimeter of that enclosure.
Hungry dinosaurs make me nervous.
Can't disagree with you there.
You know, what's the end goal? Is it just save the dinosaurs, or is there more of a through plotline?
Copy. Okay. We need to get a full assessment of the dinosaur's health. Utilize a Ranger Team vehicle.
Ranger boys!
Help get a status of the animal's overall welfare. Then, we can plan our next move.
We really need that? A plan? I mean, I've always been more of a just make it up as I go kind of guy.
Tell you what, if this doesn't work, we'll try your way.
That sort of sounds like a plan.
Ranger teams provide the latest dinosaur welfare information via status check. Construct ranger outposts inside your enclosures. I added the word out there because I was vibing with it. Just leave me alone. And ranger teams can be assigned to patrol ranger posts. Whole new mechanic. As a monster climbs up my throat, a whole new mechanic for Evolution 2. So we zoom. Approach and then switch to binoculars. Right, at the moment I've got a gun out, I'm pretty sure. Oh no, I don't. Wait, we should be good. There we go. We just needed to be a little closer. Click. Condition reported. Missing rock.
While we can't replicate what we had on the islands, we still have to do what we can to get the dinosaurs more comfortable with their current surroundings here in Arizona.
Sunscreen and drinks by the pool? How's that sound?
Are you seriously asking? Or pretend asking?
Okay, Claire. How about we add some preferred terrain to their pens instead? Better?
Just want to spend some quality time with my Barry. See, snaps on. But the locomotion still has seems to have a little bit of a jankiness to it. Hopefully that'll get fixed over time, but not a bigger deal in my opinion. IMO, as the kiddywinks say. Probably, actually, they'll probably say something else now. My Baryonyx is on fleek, as they say. That's probably quite outdated as well. Oh, there we go. We seem to be good. Just a little, nice little rim of, I'm going to make it a rocky little lagoon kind of thing. Anything else we can check out whilst we're here? Yeah, let's get a rock. Bam. Oh, you want a rotated rock, don't you? Oh, yes, I know what you want. Rotate. Rotate. Toggle axis. Oh, yeah. Gonna make my life so much better. Unironically. So excited. Oh, he's eating a fish. He's eating a fish. Oh, he's no longer eating a fish.
You gotta monitor these dinosaurs more closely. That means setting up a ranger post inside their enclosure. It sounds crazy, I know, but this'll work. Trust me.
Make sure it covers everything. I just wanna take a little peek at the map. We've got our main area here, quite small, but then the wild area, where all the wild dinosaurs are roaming about. So this is a pretty teeny tiny map. You're not gonna probably be doing much sandbox on here if you even can. I wonder if the sandbox maps other campaign maps. That's an interesting idea. We'll have to find out. Okay, assign a ranger team to the outpost. Easy peasy. Stick that on there. Can I check decos? No, of course not.
I'm getting reports of dinosaurs running freely around the facility, Claire.
The reports may be accurate, but they don't paint a complete picture of our current status.
Angry dinosaurs on the loose. What am I missing?
They're not angry. They're simply acting on instincts. The more threatened the dinosaurs feel, the more hostile they'll become.
Especially if they sense survival is at stake.
But it is. Both theirs and ours.
Yeah, but only we know that.
Now, anyway.
We'll start by tranquilizing one of the dinosaurs from the helicopter, and then have a transport team bring it back to the facility.
Great. Do it.
Isn't that a beautiful looking Triceratops skin? Oh, no. Not in front of YouTube. Not in front of YouTube. Please, Mama. Come on. Yeah. Okay, there's a few wild trikes that need wrangling. We actually saw both of them earlier. Let's head down. Oh, there's hello. Oh, that's nice. Having a little chill-out session. You know, it's a hot day. You want to get in the pool, right? We've all been there. No, that one was optimistic, I'll admit. Like bloody sniper elite up here. There's something pretty cool about this. The thing I've been mainly curious about personally is right, we've got this mechanic, this dino wrangling mechanic, right? How do they mix this up throughout the campaign? You know, how does this change from mission to mission? Because I can't imagine we're doing this every single mission the same way. So do we build a park eventually, or I don't know. I don't know what we're gonna do. It's quite exciting. Wow, this is going really badly. Just know that I'm doing this for cinematic effect, right? It's these are the Fly Girls. It's their first day on the job. They've not had much practice yet, so you know, they're not gonna hit every single shot. We're all learning as we go. Leave me alone. Construct a new enclosure and transport. Okay, well clearly it's meant to be here. Let's make a nice, decent size enclosure for our trikes. You're gonna snap down there like a good lass? Oh, no you're not. Okay, so we need to come out here. And then hopefully that'll snap. There we go, lovely stuff. Yeah, I think that's cool. Right, trikes, let's get a move on. Very excited to check out hopefully some social interactions with these in a second and some skins and stuff like that. And we may as well set this up a little bit because I don't think this is gonna be an appropriate exhibit to say the least. Love that you can turn contour lines on right from here. Much easier. The UI in general has definitely improved. It's quite nice. And they're going to need some food. I tell you what, we'll wait for that because I want to check out some of the mechanics associated. They are going to need a ranger outpost. Actually, they might not. If they all happen to come, if I put all the water over here and they all come stand over here, we wouldn't actually need a ranger outpost. As it is, we'll just stick it right bang in the middle. On the speed up time. Transporting asset. Wild area, isn't that a cool idea? It's like the concept of Isla Sauna, which we were all a bit disappointed with in the last game, but cool, basically. Okay, let's get our ranger team. Oh, I didn't rename the ranger team. Oopsie daisy. We gotta do that. They need a better name. I've got the Fly Girls and the Drive Boys. I'm not gonna say Drive Boys is a particularly good name either, but it is what it is. Now, this is actually all we have to do so far. Let's check out the skin. That skin is awesome looking. I don't think that's the default one, surely. Can we get genetic info? Right now, a little bit of info on preferences, dislikes over ceratopsids. Likes Compsognathus, that's an interesting one.
Operations are improving. I'm confident we may get a handle on this yet. But I'm also concerned, specifically about our biodiversity. Still, for now, let's focus on getting the dinosaurs safe and secure, as well as building some additional viewing galleries the DFW staff can use to monitor the animals.
Dinosaurs of the same species form territory around them as they move. Dinosaurs only consider area inside their territory when determining comfort level. Territory is not frequently visited, shrinks over time to match the latest changes to the dinosaur's environment. Cool. Interesting new system, very excited to see how that is balanced together. You are really struggling over there, aren't you? I call them the Drive Boys, they get all egotistical and they screw up. Absolutely typical. You give someone such a cool name as the Drive Boys, it goes to the head. It's just the fact of life. Bloody Drive Boys. Fly Girls, you've been much better. Well done. Boys with B-O-I-S kind of works. Girls, what can I do? G-U-R-L-S, I guess? I'll do that. If I knew more about Top Gun, that's what I'd name them after. I call them Maverick. The Mavericks. It's a good band name. Right. I know the dinos, the trikes need a little something something, but you better come over here. I might have to put another viewing gallery over on this side, actually. Just to facilitate making sure they're all matched up. I don't see the why not, right, in theory? Otherwise, we have to hope that all the trikes decide to come and hang out in the same location. I really like this kind of what they've done here, in that we've got you know, these are research buildings. They're not designed to look pretty. They're here to do a job. They're serious buildings. They're all very utilitarian to an extent. The viewing gallery is very bare bones. We got scanned. Right, okay, so what we need. So I want to try this out. So we click here, and then we click Edit Environment. And it comes up with the things that we particularly need to make the dinosaurs happy. These blue dotted items. So I think that's a really nice little feature. It's going to make it a lot easier to make your dinos happy anyway. Ground fiber for days! Give them a nice lush environment. Maybe chuck a few of these in as well. I don't worry too much about this kind of thing at the moment, but well, they seem happy. Can I find out about your skin? No.
Tell me about your skin!
Sorry. it's not the first time I've said that. Lots more information than we ever had in the past. Database entry. There we go. Oh, cool. It shows what films it showed up in. Oh, that's awesome. Jurassic World database tracks things, research items, blah, blah. Each unlock gives access in sandbox mode. Look at the information. I like that. Okay, the trike always shows up. And it's nice that they've put it in Jurassic Park 3 because it is barely in Jurassic Park 3.
With so many of the animals running free, our priority has to be capturing as many of them as possible. We can coordinate our efforts from an expedition center. Get one built, and we'll take it from there.
Okay, I want to try to line that up a little bit. Because the problem is, if you miss this a teeny bit, which I have, it looks horrible. So what we have to do is adjust and go like that. I'm not having a slightly bent path, it's not happening. Check out our guests. Who are they? Yeah, they're all Ah, they're still pointing. They love those trees. What can I say? Oh, hello. What did you do? That was a bit funky. Yeah, they're just kind of... They all kind of look like Steve Irwin, basically. Let's pretend it's a nice homage to Steve Irwin. That's what I'd like to pretend. Can I make decos yet? Curse you, game!
I'll be able to track the dinosaurs, but some help would sure be appreciated. Claire tells me there are some candidates to recruit. Scientists. Hopefully you can find one as rough and tumble as I am.
I want to watch his little jog. Scientists, key members of staff needed to perform tasks, browse the recruitment page to see which are available. Scientists have three types of skills: logistics, genetics, and welfare. Each task has a set of skill requirements that need to be met by the assigned scientists. Oversubscribing a skill decreases the time and cost. Look at him jog! Look at her jog, I should say. I call you Joggo. It's a proper name. You look beautiful. Hello, Joggo. I'm very inventive with my names. It jogs, we'll call it Joggo! Let's go grab the scientist. Oh yeah, C hops straight into capture mode, that's cool. Right, so we need to go control center? Yep. We're gonna recruit now. Who is the craziest? That's really the important thing. Fitness fanatic runs monthly half marathons. Popular social media account, right, you're out. Degree in France from the University of Copenhagen led to a job in banking and a champion go-kart racer. Greer, you are winning. That's quite tame. Okay, Greer, you're my man. His stats are rubbish, but you're my man. Oh, we can get two. Oh, well, we'll mix it up.
You seeing this, Claire?
Yeah, I sure am. This is our first live capture opportunity.
Let's not miss it.
We should assign that scientist you just hired to the task. Agreed? Owen, you there? I think you're still muted.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Good idea. What have we got to lose? You know, except maybe a new recruit.
I don't know if this is a thing during Sandbox and Challenge, which definitely nothing we ever saw, but the idea that instead of just going for fossils, we're actually sending our team out to verify the location of these dinosaurs in the wild, and then obviously saving them, inverted commas. It's a pretty cool idea. Should we send both out? Let's send both out. Why not?
Before the remote capture teams return, we should have enclosures ready for the dinosaurs. Think of it as welcoming them back home.
Just prepping size-wise there. So this is for the Stegosaurus. And there is four of them, so we need to make it pretty chunky habitat, I would suggest. It's going to be more tall than anything. It's not going to be that tall either. At the end, I mean, that's plenty, right? That's, yeah, it's fairly humongous, really. Let's go up. Beautiful stuff. Ooh. Look at this! And this cool live capture report from Nevada. Took 38 seconds, captured 4 stegosaurs. Cool. Yeah, we're fine. Let's kick it off. Here we go. Okay, and we need a gate. So this is our basic routine, I suppose, for things. You need a fences, you need a gate, you need a ranger outpost in particular, and I think it's a good idea to maybe assign them to that ranger outpost nice and early. What I would like is actually another ranger team, because they're going to head out there, but I don't think I can get one. We can always do it manually, though. We need a little bit of water. I mean, it's not much different than the first game. You just need a ranger team. And sort of more control over the environment. You know, that's very much a thing. Like a ring. And we need some power as well. These make me nervous, these backup generators, man. I don't want to use them at all. Nothing but death and destruction this way lies, I'm telling you. You just wait and see. So yeah, the ranger team's now gonna go check on the trikes. I think I might just control this one manually.
Okay. Who's watching who?
I'm not following you, Owen.
Well, it's just like the dinosaurs are always watching us, so shouldn't we be watching them?
Yes, we should. Once we have the dinosaurs comfortably settled into their enclosures, we'll need viewing galleries.
What I'm saying. Only you said it.
Hey, what if I swap to the flare? Is that good? Oh! Oh, they love it! Oh! Doesn't the skin texture look really, really good? It's definitely improved from that. Oh, hello! They're all very excited about this flare. Calling the mothership. Oh, you don't. Do you want a flare? There you go, buddy. Everyone deserves a flare. Oh, wow, they're still excited. That's pretty cool. Now that's a new thing, but still. Okay, so what are we lacking in comfort? Ground fruit. Can I just... Can you go do that now? And then we need to... Yeah, there we go. Sweet. Right, missing ground fruit. Let's work on that. Technically, you really only need to scan one of them, right? Because, right, none of that provides ground fruit. I'm confused. That does. Okay, surely it's this one that I need. Nice lush environment. Oh, they need some ground fiber as well, that's why. There we go. And no more blue markers because they are perfectly happy. We've got some ornamental ones as well, so these are just, what, for style purposes? Some proper little shrubberies. Hello. Yeah, the skin looks fantastic. It really does. Let's get some info. Dislikes carnivores, ceratopsids, ankylosaurids, stegosaurids. A lot of dinosaurs in this game are self-hating, to say the least. Oh. Social interaction. It's a little bit like the Rex one in a weird way. Oh, I should have got my thumbnail. There we go. Oh, we have research. Oh, sorry, that's my bad. I completely missed the that little doohickey there. Good old building restraints has returned. It would be sad if it didn't come back at all. You know, it's something. It's part of who we are now. Yeah, it's a beautiful skin. Love that. I was always a little concerned that the new pattern system would lead to sometimes dull-looking dinosaurs, but if they all looked like this, it wouldn't be a problem. That is gorgeous stuff. A little snooze. Is this a snooze or a sit? It's a sit. Oh. Proper hefty. Oh, I think we've got a sandstorm coming.
Owen, we have a real problem.
I'm trying, Clara, but it's just, well, this is who I am.
Not you.
Ah, the dinosaurs. Tell me something I don't know.
Okay, how about this? There's a massive sandstorm headed our way, and it could wipe out the facility. Without power, the safety of the dinosaurs could be at serious risk.
Okay, listen to me, Claire. We'll figure this out. Have I ever let you down before?
Actually, no.
And I'm planning on keeping it that way. Everything we can do, we will do. We've survived worse. What's a little sand?
Shouldn't say that, buddy. Sandstorm is here. That looks pretty cool. So what does the sandstorm do? It can hurt your dinosaurs. It can break your vehicles, I believe. Right, Barry, where you at? Barry's chilling. Whoa, Barry! Barry, no! Barry's so angry about the fence! Ooh. Okay. I mean, I don't need money.
I gotta say, I'm feeling pretty concerned about our current situation. As much as I'd obviously love to help out, I'm a little tied up. So, who's gonna protect the dinosaurs?
And our personnel?
Yes, of course. I mean, that goes without saying.
I'm saying it anyway.
It's just, it would be a tragedy to lose these animals again. And by tragedy, I mean huge financial loss. And obviously an embarrassment to those in charge of the DFW.
People such as you?
Well, actually, exactly me. So, how do we avoid that?
Okay, step one. Round up the stragglers and get all the dinosaurs back into their enclosures. Then we'll work on our safety rings.
This good?
Yes, this is a plan I can support now and take credit for later.
Fly boys, wait no, drive boys, fly girls, assemble. I was really hoping to see Barry kill someone. What can I say? Open emergency shelters, tranquilize each rampaging dinosaur using A-mode or lock-on, which is new. Transport dinosaurs back into their enclosures before they wake up again. Rampaging dinosaurs break up on your fence, select a response facility using R. Yeah. Everyone seems pretty chill about it. There's a massive sandstorm going on, and a dinosaur. Also, T no longer does transport, which is interesting. That used to be a button I used a lot. But now I suppose it's right there on the left. It's pretty easy as well. Get that fence repaired, team. We'll be good. We're looking good. But it is only a 2. I assume Baryonyx is, what, maybe a 3? It's a 4. Bloody Nora. Baryonyx is a big boy. So I think that's what we're going to go through here. How to upgrade the fence, basically. Speed up time a little bit. Apparently he's safely enclosed. The wobbly boy. Oh, no. That's tracking my trike and my, yeah. I'm sorry, Stegos, I wasn't signing you correctly. I'm herding together. They do move in herds. Happy Alan Grant voice. Happy Alan Grant noises. There we go, first mission complete.
Arizona was secure. The dinosaurs were safe. Finch and the DFW had what they needed to keep the bureaucrats off our backs. For now. But the future, that was something completely different.
Okay, well, next mission is Washington. Of course, that's the one from the, that you guys have already seen and that I've already played myself. And we're gonna save this for the next video. So thank you so much for joining me for the start of this playthrough. I will see you lovely folks there in the snowstorm. Cheers much of as always. Please do throw me a like down below. Bye-bye. Reaching out.